So tell us more about what's going on with this one.
Well, Yvette Cooper is determined to crack down on the number of illegal immigrants working in various industries across the UK. So car washes, nail bars tend to be the obvious ones. The Home Secretary is hopeful that the way to solving the illegal immigration crisis is to up the number of deportations. And she might have a point. According to the statistics that were released earlier this week, the number of small boat arrivals are actually going down. But the problem is that of those who come here, a very small proportion are actually being deported. Most of them are just getting into either sort of the black market of work or end up claiming asylum after a very, very long and drawn out process. So Yvette Cooper's trying to sort of up the number of... She's been going around, well, not her, but her police officers have been going around the UK sort of seizing these illegal workers. And hopefully she thinks that will bring an end or at least massively reduce the numbers of illegal immigrants over here. The Conservatives don't think that this is the sort of silver bullet to the illegal immigration crisis. And obviously the question to Keir Starmer and Yvette Cooper is, OK, yes, maybe you can make a dent in the number of illegal migrants who are already here, but while there's no disincentive for people to come over here, it's a sort of never-ending problem. You solve the people who are here, but then you have a huge, huge influx of people arriving in small boats. And that's why the Conservative Party wanted to do the Rwanda plan as a sort of disincentive to stop migrants from coming here. Of course, that didn't work. It's been completely abandoned by this government and they're trying a totally different tack. I wonder if they'll have any more success.
Olivia, look, of course it's brilliant. In theory, it's brilliant. But as I said, the devil in the detail is that 75 illegal migrant workers is just literally a drop in the ocean considering the illegal migration figures we're currently seeing.
Well, exactly, and I mean that is a huge part of the problem. It's looking as though in every from the raids that they've done so far, in one in every three organisations, they're finding an average of one illegal migrant working there. This is a very, very resource intensive programme that Yvette Cooper is running, and so far we just don't really seem to be seeing the results. Perhaps what the Home Secretary is hoping is that, much like the idea behind the Rwanda plan, if illegal immigrants can see that those who come here and try and get into the work system can't stay, end up being deported, then perhaps they won't come at all. But, you know, that might be a little bit far-fetched. Not all of the migrants who are coming over here in small boats want to get into the black market of work. Lots of them are hopeful that they're going to be able to claim asylum when they get here, which is a very different story altogether. So it may work as a disincentive a little bit, but it may not quite have the effect that the Home Secretary is hoping for. And as for actual results compared to resources, so far it doesn't seem to be particularly cost effective.
Yeah, and Olivia, just quickly before you go, given that we saw the figures released this week that many of the people in the boats coming over, the vast majority were from Afghanistan, and we understand why they're fleeing Afghanistan, but we can't deport people back to Afghanistan, can we? So since we've got rid of the Rwanda deal, what is Yvette Cooper planning to do with the illegal migrants who have come from Afghanistan? I mean, what's she going to do with them? Where's she going to send them?
Well, that's a really, really good question. I think I'm right in saying that 94% of the migrants who come over here come from countries where we wouldn't be able to deport them and probably wouldn't want to deport them. So what is she going to do about that? The Labour Party so far doesn't really seem to have an answer. I was speaking to Mike Tapp, the Labour MP this morning, who's the MP for Dover and Deal, right on the front line of the immigration crisis. And he was maintaining the line that Keir Starmer is just going to smash the gangs. Well, smashing the gangs is obviously easier said than done. Rishi Sunak clearly wanted to break up the criminal gangs that are responsible for the people smuggling trade in the Channel. But there isn't some sort of big boss man who can just be taken out like in a sort of primetime crime drama. These are very nimble gangs. They're small gangs. They're very broken up. They're dispersed. If one is broken down and taken out, then another another one will start up a few miles down the channel. This is a really, really difficult problem to address. It's sort of Medusa's head, cut off one and another just emerges. And apart from that, we don't really have more flesh on the bones of how Labour is going to deal with the illegal immigration crisis.
A good point, very well made. Thank you very much, Olivia Utley, political correspondent of GB News. Thank you. OK, now, huge debate. I mean, no one seems to have any answers to this, so let's see if the panel can supply a little bit of an answer. Nigel, I'm looking at you, Nigel Nelson. You're on Team Yvette Cooper, aren't you?
I certainly am, yes.
The numbers are 75. I mean, considering the numbers we see coming
over here. Yeah, this is just in a week, though. I mean, they started this on Monday, so they've caught those in a week. I mean, when Claire was at the Home Office, that she was catching these people, so I don't know if she caught more of these illegal workers than Yvette Cooper has. The big difference here is you've taken 1,000 people, 1,000 civil servants away from the Rwanda programme and you've put them on enforcement. So the argument would be, if that works, that you will catch more people over a period of time by doing that.
But the same questions asked Olivia. If these people happen to be from a country where we can't deport them, Afghanistan, which is where many of the small boat migrants are coming from at the moment, what do we do with them? We can't send them back to Afghanistan. We could have sent them back to... We sent them to Rwanda, had that scheme been operating. It's not now, so... What does Yvette Cooper do with them?
Well, I mean, when it comes to Rwanda, we'd have only ever sent 300 there initially anyway, so that would hardly make a dent in the people coming across the channel. What has happened under the Illegal Migration Act is that you can't send people out of the country, but they can't stay either. They're inadmissible because they've come across the channel. Your only answer there is to process the asylum claims that are genuine and weed out the ones which aren't genuine. Then you have to see which of those can be sent back to a safe country.
But if it's Afghanistan, they can't go
there.
No,
they can't. No, you're absolutely right. I mean, in a sense, we should have got Afghanistan resettlement scheme much better sorted out. We did pretty well with Ukrainians, pretty well with the Syrians. We did very badly with the Afghans, who, in fairness, they put their lives on the line to help us during the war.
Yes, no, many of them did. So, Claire, how many illegal migrants did you take when you were at the Home Office?
Well, that's obviously couldn't possibly comment on their operation. Numbers, but it is a really interesting one, and it's all very well to go round and arrest 75 individuals for illegal working. Yeah, great, that's marvellous. But what are you doing about the people that are bringing them over here in the first place? You can say you're going to smash the gangs, but you're not really doing that. And when you look at the penalties involved for those people, if you do catch them, they're not particularly high. Then this is an industry that is worth billions of pounds.
Yes.
And if you're talking about maybe 3 years in prison, if you're lucky, probably out in about 18 months. No, and this is going back, then it's not much of a disincentive, really, because 18 months you'll be out, it'll be a junior sort of gang member, it's never going to be the higher ups. So there isn't that disincentive. And just by taking 75 workers out of that...
In a week.
Yes, and how many hours and thousands and thousands of taxpayers' money has been spent to just remove those 75 people?
You would accept that enforcement is about doing that, is about planning, about spending money, about catching the right people. I mean, that's how the police operate they're catching crooks.
OK, but you're catching those people who are working in those kind of industries, but you're not actually dealing with the major problem of, smashing the gangs, which we've heard enough of this year from Keir Starmer. What about that? How is that going? Because at the moment, I see absolutely nothing being done on smashing the gangs. It doesn't matter how many Labour MPs
they've only had 50 days to actually do this.
But you're lording over 75 individuals being taken out of the black economy.
It's a start.
So you can't have it always.
I appreciate it's not a huge number, and there are probably thousands of people doing this. But you have to start somewhere. I think it's quite reasonable to spend the time and resources
quite an easy,
on catching those people.
It's quite an easy target. When you're looking at where do illegal workers tend to end up, and it's places like nail bars, it is places like car washes, the sex industry, and maybe some restaurants. So, you know, those are quite easy to go after. It's quite low-hanging fruit. But there has been no work done on the smashing of the gangs. And we keep hearing about it.
50 days. I mean, give them a chance to get the new, the new border security command up and running.
Which they haven't even recruited the main person into that role yet.
But it's been
now,
50
I would have thought, yeah. And, well, you're saying that's not enough time to recruit somebody to for one
not
of your
get,
major
not, not
flagship
to get a major
policies.
Law enforcement force up in action.
You don't think that was important.
Time. But, I mean, what Yvette Cooper has done is been able to recruit these 1,000 people for enforcement. They were the ones who were working on the ridiculous Rwanda
So they're not
scheme.
Really necessarily been recruited. They've just been reassigned.
Mm. Yeah, OK.
So, all right, so there's a little bit of fudging of some figures
Yes, they've been reassigned to a different job, but probably a better job than than wasting their time on Rwanda, which wouldn't have worked in the first place.
Yeah, well, I don't disagree with that. But I think if you are looking to make a real difference, you do need to look at the criminal gangs. You need to look at the gang masters who bring these people in, and you have to look at the trafficking routes. There is so much that they haven't done yet, and all
but
of their grand talking.
I mean, that's what the Tories were doing, weren't they? So they were talking about smashing the criminal gangs. The question really is this a better way of doing it by using counter-terror laws to try and catch them? So you're bringing in spies from MI5 and things like that to make it easier. So, but it is early days yet. I mean, you're not going to be able to do this within a couple of weeks, are you?
Well, the thing is with this, where there's a will, there's a way, right? I mean, they get things moving pretty damn fast with the rioters. I mean, you sort of like 1 minute you were... I'm not condoning rioting, by the way, before anyone says anything. 1 minute you're chucking a brick, the next you're in court and you're in jail. So Keir Starmer can to get his bottom in gear, to put it politely, when he needs to. So 50 days and they still, as Claire points out, haven't recruited someone who's in charge.
But they were
it.
Caught by existing law enforcement agencies. We're talking about creating a new one.
Yeah, no, but giving someone the job in charge of it, that doesn't take 50 days.
No. Surely, if that has been your main policy idea, you would have an idea of who you wanted for that role. You would have opened up the recruitment as soon as you were in power to do
but
so.
The recruitment is opened up. They just haven't found the person yet.
But as Dawn said, where there's a will, there's a way. And if you can get people through the criminal justice system very quickly for riots...
Well, you know what? Actually, you know what? for once, Nigel Nelson, the three people around this desk possibly in agreement, I totally agree. I mean, actually, Team Claire, all the way. You'd do a brilliant job. You'd have had that job filled straight away and sorted this problem.
There you go. Thank you.
Yes.